added value, which is precisely what developing countries and least developed countries should be focusing on. Because many countries, many developing countries and many least developed countries have fallen into the what is called the resource curse, which is just exporting prime and raw material or resources with no added value. So the added value of those resources goes out of the country. All that is left is just, you know, the commodity trading, that's all. But with this approach, we can establish a mechanism, a system by which at the end of their tenure as apprentices, they are fully certified and qualified professionals in the sector they've chosen, be it plumbing, be it electricians, be it mechanics, and mechanics can be quite wide-ranging activity, and several other occupations. Just think of somebody that is 17 or 18 that has a certain level of practical experience that is certified and qualified to start their activity at a professional level and can start providing for their family, their parents, their siblings, and creating an impact upon their community. That's why I think, you know, instead of focusing on foreign aid and direct foreign investment, direct foreign investment is very good, yes. But why not focus it in a different way? That instead of transferring the technology so that certain manufacturing can be replicated, why not dedicate a part of that foreign direct investment that should be dedicated to skills training, but at the national level of a country? I think that that investment would pay back enormously in the short to midterm, but really enormously. It could create such an impact upon the communities and the country, but not only that, it would change lives so dramatically that, I find it difficult to find words to adequately describe it. Over to you, sir.
So thank you very much. Actually, you have proposed a wonderful solution to unemployment problem. Because in the developing country, unemployment is one of the major challenges. So you showed how to reduce unemployment through apprenticeship during the education and skills-based occupational education. Because if, for example, like in Bangladesh, we have several systems of education. We have general line education, we have science education, we have commerce education, we have arts or humanities education, law background, and so many. We have school education, Madrasa education, we have English medium education, Bengali medium education, Bengali English version of Bengali medium education, and many more. So besides all these systems of education, these are producing higher educated graduates, but without required skills. Therefore, they are suffering to get a job. So why? In Bangladesh, we are sending 100 million people, almost 10 million population in abroad every year, but just as low-skilled and semi-skilled worker. But if we can ensure their training and skills, whatever you have mentioned, then they can earn even 10 times more than current earnings. Besides, we have many unemployment, about 5 million maybe, 5 million unemployed youth currently, if we can ensure their apprenticeship in industry, their skills development from the very beginning of their primary education, then obviously this unemployment problem will be reduced. As you said, Germany has the lowest rate of unemployment. So unemployment not only harming the family, but also harmful for the nation, because this unemployment youth are becoming frustrated. Then they became restless. So in this connection, I would like to know from you, what are the risks of restlessness and frustration of youth? Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much. And I greatly appreciate your question, because the risk of restlessness and frustration of youth is not only that they will fall into the trap of organized crime networks that exist the world over, which will create or even make worse the situation of their families and their communities. But for example, I can tell you that I live in a country that is basically separated from North Africa by only 14 kilometers, okay, which is the Strait of Gibraltar. And we receive many migrants. And I don't use the word illegal, because I don't think anybody is illegal on this planet, okay? When they talk about illegal immigration, no. Nobody's illegal on this planet. Nobody. Let's say irregular immigration. Many of them come from sub-Saharan Africa. And many of them are young. It is a very strange day when at one of the beaches in the south of my country, in Spain, the people or even the police find bodies that have washed up on the shore of these youths coming from sub-Saharan Africa, trying to make the journey and cross over into Europe, seeking a future, seeking opportunity. And that's not counting, because nobody really knows how many lose their lives just on the journey from their countries in sub-Saharan Africa up to the north of Africa. The situation is the same. The situation is practically the same regarding Latin America and the United States. You can just check the media of how many tens of thousands try to enter the United States because their countries, the young people just don't see any future. They don't have any opportunities. So that is the risk. That is one of the risks of the restlessness and frustration. If you think about it, regardless of their education level and so on, what we are talking about is a brain drain. Brain drain of people, young people, that are hungry, as we indicated before, that are hungry for skills, for knowledge, for opportunities to make a living for themselves, okay? You must forgive me, I'm not familiar with the situation in your country, but you've indicated that you also face a brain drain of young people immigrating from Bangladesh. And as you can see, the situation exists in other places, in Africa, in Latin America, it's exactly the same. People, young people, not only men, but also women, seeking opportunities. but in many cases, even families. I can give you the example, okay, of there's a prestigious football club up in the north of Spain, in the city of Bilbao. And they're one of the best players they have. He's very young. He's 21. His name is Iñaki Williams. He was born in that city in Bilbao. But his parents are from Ghana. They made the journey with his mother pregnant with him, crossing a large part of Africa, crossing the strait to reach Spain, seeking a better future, seeking opportunities, not only for them, but for their son. And now he's one of the top players in this football club. And that's just an example, okay? So an example of how hungry, how needy the youth are to be given an opportunity, to be given a modicum of support. They're not asking things for free. They're just asking for support and opportunities. The rest, they'll do themselves. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Actually, you have showed us that how opportunity-less people, I mean, jobless people, unemployed people can just travel 1,000 kilometers from Africa to Europe. Same scenario from Latin American countries to USA. And also from Bangladesh and other South Asian least developed countries or developing countries, our youth, a large number of our youth, they are always dreaming to enter into any